it was the family, because personally my family teach me the music, but also it was all the music that we were listening to, the radio and the TV. And I remember that at this age, you know, you don't really understand the music, but you just feel the waves. And when you are a teenager, like you begin to be like 14 or 15, you understand more the chords and the music, so you are more able to reproduce it. But I think that you know, it's when you are a musician, you are always trying to reproduce the basic waves of what you used to hear when you were very, very young, because it was like magic at this time. I think it was the radio, you know. I suppose that's a kind of Beatles thing, you know, and also like the French mainstream at this time, which was very like romantic.
Our parents knew that you can make a lot of money by being musicians, so they taught us music for fun, but my family didn't insist too much. I mean, they give me the minimum and they taught me how to enjoy music and how to play an instrument, because it's a tradition in my family. But they wanted me to have a serious job. A classic story: we were in school together at the high school. So everybody, I think all the bad pupils were doing bands, which was very optimistic when you're French, because French are good at other things than making bands. Pop or rock bands, you know, but we didn't care and we did it. It was, you know, when you're a teenager, you have all this energy in you, so you just want to play loud and fast. It's very healthy when you're young to do that. And the more you grow up, the more you calm down. And so when we started Air, we reached a level where we couldn't be more calm, because I think we try to do the slowest song ever recorded. I think the BPM of Le Soleil est près de moi is like 61 or 62, something like that. It's very slow.
I think the best is not to try to be influenced. I think that doing music and composing is just trying to do a sort of research and to search the music that you like. Because there is no creation, actually, in music. There is like transformation. And we just tried, you know, to translate some really strange emotions that we feel in music. And basically, we just record all the time. You know, we just try to experiment. And then we try to design the music. You know, there is like a sort of inspiration phase. And then we design the music like we could design an object.
Great opportunity for us to do exactly what we wanted to do. Like, there was a huge artistic freedom at Source, and basically it was just a label that was made to be cool. There was no all the first singles that were released, it was just for the image, you know, and not really, they didn't try to make money with it. And so it was we worked at our beginning with this huge freedom and with that pressure. And now Source is closed, because in France you can go on like that, because at that point it was not a label that made money. And so all this, they used to make compilations with like 20 artists that have no, you know, it was very, there was a great enthusiasm for something very new and fresh. And and then they realized when we did Moon Safari that it has a huge commercial potential, and that's how things started to change. I think making an album fresh and unique and but intimist too. But we didn't think of its commercial potential, and I think that's why we try to keep. It's we use a lot of energy to protect us from any pressure in a commercial way. And when we close the door of the studio, it's easy for us to remember the time when we were 15 or 16 or 17 years old, and we were in our bedroom and making music. We are in the same spirit, and it worked pretty well. And we do music and whatever happens, happens. Sometimes it's commercial, sometimes it's not.
It was not a success in the next 3 months after the release. It took like 3 years. So, you know, it was very progressive. We had the time, you know, to get used to it. And also, you know, it would be so cool to be able to do some hits, some radio hits. But the problem is that we can't because we don't have the science of it. And so every kind of success is a sort of mistake. Virgin Suicide is a sort of album around the soundtrack of Virgin Suicide. It's an album because there are some songs, and also it's a soundtrack because the tracks have been made to fit the movie. So it's like, I think at this time we wanted to be dark. We discovered our dark aspect, and we wanted to play with this kind of feeling. And also the movie was really dark too, because it was about suicide and girls attracted by death, which was the most influential feeling of this music, you know, the attraction that you can feel for death. And also the feelings were also like some romantic feelings, because there are so many love stories in the movie. So, you know, that's why we did Playground Love, which is a love song, but a teenager love song, you know. It was completely different because we did Playground Love, we did Virgin Suicide in 3 months, and Moon Safari was longer than that.
When we did Moon Safari, we were very shy, and so we wanted to go more far in the experimentation. And I think it's... And for us, it's very fresh, and it was an exciting album. But people consider that it was prog or pretentious, which is very weird. Because we recorded in a very little studio, like smaller than that, with all our machines. And it was more an album with all our gadgets. We wanted to play with all the gadgets that were here, and to invite all our friends we met after Moon Safari. So, and I think we tried to do the most beautiful song. We wanted to be at the top, you know. And so it's funny when you want to do something and the people reaction, they don't see the same thing as you. And so it's a great. We learn a lot from that. And you can apply that in our everyday life all the time. Like if you want to. If your intention is something, people don't see that intention. They see something else. So so it's very bizarre. We still believe in the songs. We play them on stage. We really want to insist. And I'm sure one day people realize it's really, we're really proud of this album. And it's still it's a disappointment because in terms of business, they always see. The sales compared to the album before, so it was less than that, but it's still a lot of people liked it still, and a lot of people trip on it, and there's a lot of I don't know, and still I remember it was an important album for our credibility, because now after that album we traveled around the world, all the musicians and all the producers, they really. They see us as good musicians, good composers, and not from a marketing, because with Moon Safari we were a fashion product. So I think 10,000 Heads was very important for us to install us as producers and musicians and composers. It's Nigel Godrich who produced the mix and co-produced some of the album. He said. Your voice sounds cool, and the French accent is not a problem. It makes a style, it's original. So I think we just need someone that we could trust who tells us that. So if as we trust him, we believe him. But if someone else would have told us that, we would not have believed it. And also, we think being two producer and having guest singer is something, it belongs for us to the 90s. Like, it's something now, all the bands did that, and the Chemical Brothers or Death in Vegas or Us or Daft Punk or I mean, it was everywhere, this combination, like two producers with guest singers. And we thought it was very, we were fed up of that. So we decided to sing all the songs ourselves. As we use English, it's very easy because we hide behind English. So I couldn't say these things in French because I'm too much shy. I prefer keep things like that for myself. But in English, it's like you dare to say it. You get the guts to say things that you would not never say in French. We keep the fun the most first priority when we work. And so we were excited to do that. And it was fun. And we can say some personal things. So the album was much more personal. And it fits because it was our purpose to do a personal album. And we felt mature enough to express some personal feelings in it. I mean, the only key is to do something unique all the time. And we like to explore new things all the time, and if we are not able to do that anymore, we will stop. But as long as we find new things to experiment, we will do music all the time. We can't stop making music. We do music all the time. We did 6 albums in 6 years, and we have many other projects, and so. But we're really instinctive. We follow our instincts. We do what we feel doing. We don't plan in the future.
You know, before, when I was recording some songs, I was saying to myself that okay, it's so cool because what I play will be kept forever, and so it's a step for immortality. But I thought a lot about that, and I think that art in general is ephemeral, you know what I mean? It's like our music will die and will disappear one day.
You don't have to think too much of what you're doing, just have the only thing, is the key thing is to find a good reason to wake up in the morning and do something. And but don't do things for the others or for the future or for the posterity. It's the worst way to make records.